I was watching a man last night in this public group of men that's leading this group in this class that we're in. A powerful man. A successful man. I respect this man. I love how he's leading this group and how he's calling out foolishness with a few of the men that weren't obeying rules. And he had to get on me one time. I had a hat on. I didn't know that he didn't want hats. And I just love that you can just call the men out and just do it. And he's good and he's right. And we're going through these classes of man, you know, what we're supposed to do and how we're supposed to be as men and learning these methods. And it's a great class. He's facilitating it great. And one thing we deal with in this group with men is being honest about our feelings, being honest about what's really going on, and not lying. That's a foundational truth that we're trying to deal with these group of men, is not lying. And in our own coaching programs, teaching men to not lie. And knowing that a lot of us are lying, most of the time we spent most of our life lying. Half the time we don't even know that we're lying. Okay, it's just a second language for so many people in the world. We're just lying and calling out that crap and all the other crap that we as men deal with, and holding each other accountable. And in this group, it's a safe place to be honest and vulnerable and be truthful and let other men call us out. It's great. I've been in it for 4 years. It's helped me. It's tremendous. And I just keep growing and I just keep learning. And it's tremendous. And this new coach with the group is doing a tremendous job. And he's being vulnerable with us about situation with his wife. He's talking about the difficulties they're having right now, her frustrations right now, and what they should do about it. And he's in a situation right now that I believe they've talked about. I believe they have agreed to. I believe they got a great relationship, but he's away from his wife and two young children every other week for a full week. And so that's where he is right now, and she's expressing her frustration in general. I don't know that she's saying anything about him being away, but she is feeling alone. She's feeling lonely. She's feeling frustrated. And he's expressing that about, hey, we have things that we have to deal with. I've got to go home tonight, and I have to have this conversation with my wife, and we have to figure out what we need to do and how to do it and what's the best course of action. And we're going to have to, we use the word collide. And he's being right. He's being vulnerable. He's being honest. And he's setting the example for us other men. And I praise him for that. But in a private chat, I sent the message that would it be good for her if you quit doing this thing in your life right now where you're away from her a week at a time? Would that help her? Now, I know it would. I know it's the right thing to do. I know, because of how human beings are, because of how women are, because of how men are, because of how marriage is, because of how difficult it is, because of all the failed marriages, because of all the failings I made in my own marriage and the mistakes and the times that I wasn't there for my wife, I know that's what he needs to do. I just know it. But later on in his discussion, where he's teaching us powerfully again, he references that a man had said this to him, and he said it might help in the short term, but she wouldn't respect me in the long run. So the lesson I want you to learn from here is, no matter how good and powerful we are, we're all going to catch ourselves in a moment where we're not being honest, and we're not looking at it right. We were triggered, we're mad, or we just say something that's not true. And it's based upon the future. We need to do what's right in the moment and leave the consequences up to God and quit thinking about what the future is going to bring. And we also need to make sure that our marriage, especially as men, that our wife is our number one priority. And when we melt it all down, get it all down to brass tacks, the number one priority in our life as men is to our wives. Always to our wives. And if our wife is not feeling satisfied or helped, we need to do whatever we need to do to make her feel that way. And in the meantime, keep your eyes on him.